Battleship.
I'm on a boat. I'm on a boat. Everybody look at me, cause I'm sailing on a boat. I'm on a boat. I'm on a boat. Take a good hard look at the motherfucking boat.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the next episode of the What Is This Blank podcast. This week we are first of all, actually, thank you for all of our YouTube success. We're right up there with, you know, like the, you know, the top subscribed channels now. I think there's like four commas in our subscriber numbers, but we need more. So keep coming, keep subscribing. And you know, Kevin's pumping out that content. It's going to get up there. You have to bear with us. If you liked some of our older episodes, we didn't have video for those. Because that was pre-pandemic, so we met face-to-face. I know, that's weird, but that's how we did things. That's how we did things in the olden days. People came together, you see? They met in the same room, and they talked face-to-face. I could see you. I could touch you if I wanted to. I could touch you. I could reach out. And I can't do that anymore.
Whatever you say, Grandpa.
Well, yeah, you know? Coca-Cola was a nickel. Now, if you order on Uber Eats, it's about $4 for the same. All right. So, this week, this episode, I guess I can't really say week because these things come out whenever. This episode, we're talking about the 2012 movie, Battleship, starring Rihanna. That's the only star I'm going to mention. Oh, Liam Neeson's is in it. Liam Neeson's. He's in it. For about 5 minutes. Could he use more Liam Neeson's? So there isn't much of a synopsis that to go off of this movie. It's a guy's in the Navy. We meet him and his apparently screw up brother 5 years ago. I think it was 5 years. And they're hanging out in a bar. The guy's a screw up. Charlotte McKinney comes in. That's the blonde girl's name, if any of y'all didn't know that. I'm pretty sure it's Charlotte McKinney. Anyways.
The main girl?
The blonde, yeah.
It's Brooklyn Decker.
Oh. Yeah. Okay, well. Either way, Bameba. 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 So yeah, he tries to win her heart, and he by breaking into a gas station gets her a burrito. The younger of the brothers is a screw up. The oldest one is in the Navy, and the next morning, the Navy guy is yelling at his brother. Well, you know what? You're not screwing up. I'm getting sick of it. You're joining me in the Navy. Okay. Flash forward to what in real life should be like 10 to 12 years.
Yeah.
For how this screw up went from being a screw up in a bar who got arrested to then 5 years later, if that's the timeline, I think it was five years. They said, to now he's a lieutenant in the Navy running the gun room on a fucking battleship. Like, what? And, oh, by the way, apparently he might have just gotten to pick where he goes, because that's how the Navy works. You can just go, I would like to go to Hawaii with my brother and be on that ship, right? No, that's not how that works, bro. He's at a soccer game, which there's, like, this thing where different countries come together and they have like a war games type of thing. And so they're playing a soccer game. The one guy from the Japanese side kicks him in the face, but he's got too much pride to go out of the game. He misses the penalty shot. Okay. Anyways. So now we're on the, I've got a burp. I'm sorry. It's stuck. It wants to come out, but so now we're, let's put all these war games.
Rimpack.
The ring of mags and a Seneca. Okay, yeah, that's what all those letters stand for. I don't care what they stand for. So they go out to do these war games type of thing. And then, oh, I get shit. Okay, so 5 years ago, these nerds sent out a signal to outer space. I forgot about that part. So they sent out this signal to outer space, and this one nerd guy's like, I think this is a bad idea. I don't think we should do this. This is a bad idea. Oh, my gosh. Because he knew. Anyways. So that message finally reached somebody, and they were like, oh, no, you didn't. We are on the blocked call list. You do not call us, son. So then they send some aliens to destroy our planet, because in all the movies, that's what aliens do. They just come to suck our planet dry of all of its resources. So, now fast forward back to the war games. Well, now these aliens have showed up at Earth. They land in the ocean, and they set up this big old thing. They're starting to send their signal up, but their communication ship actually hit a satellite, which... This is one of the things that bothered me. Satellites are very fragile. They are very fragile. These ships, as we find out, are pretty strong, because they take some pretty big blows from the battleships. But the one communication ship hits the satellite, disintegrates into many pieces, destroys Hong Kong, lands. So now now the aliens can't send their signal back. But the aliens just happen to know, hey, there's a bunch of satellite dishes up there on that hill. We're going to go and connect those up, because we have the equipment here. We brought it with us just in case.
I can't use a plug in the U.S. in England, but they have plugs that they can plug into our satellites.
Yeah. Technology, same. Oh, my gosh. So, so then it sets off this, like, protective dome that they can't get in or out of. Radio signals, phone calls, nothing get in or out of. The aliens proceed to destroy like two or three of the ships. All the ships except for one, and that's the one that the screw up brother's on. And then this is another part that was... So there's a weird thing with this movie. I'm kind of jumping to my feeling of the movie real quick. In my opinion, the writing, the acting, all that type of stuff sucks balls. The storyline with the family and how they came about and how fast he progressed through the Navy, all that type of bull crap is stupid beyond belief. But the science fiction-y part of the movie, where these aliens find a signal and come down, and that's what they do in all the movies, that... The alien ships, those fucking balls that go through the thing, that stuff's kind of cool. Like, it's not... If you look at it, it's not bad graphics and CG and all that kind of stuff. It's like good. I was actually surprised, because lots of times when you watch older movies, you can really see, you know, like, the difference in the CGs and the green screen and all that kind of stuff. This one, it was hard to see where those two things were. So that was just kind of my thing. It's like, movie sucks, but that kind of stuff in the movie was good, I thought. The action stuff and that kind of shit. So anyways. Oh, so also, back to the stupid brother. So let's go through this timeline again. 5 years ago, screw up, joins the Navy. Goes to the Navy so fast that now he's a lieutenant, and he's pretty high up in the ship there. He's running the gun room. And then because he gets into a fight with another guy, he's progressed all that time, but then we find out he's always a screw up. I don't know what your problem is. You're all of it. And now he's going to be kicked out of the Navy. Like, what? Like, you don't progress that fast to that point in your career. So then all of a sudden, oh, you're such a screw up and you're going to get kicked. So anyways, that was stupid. So, I mean, and then, you know, the fight with the aliens ensue, and you know, I'm not spoiler and alerting this, because none of you are going to watch it. America. Humans win. Yay. So what do you guys got?
This just has to be like a Navy propaganda movie. It's like, so much money was pumped into this. Like you said, the CG was expensive as fuck. Like, it was good.
Yeah.
But it was just this rah rah, like, join the Navy. We got soccer. We got bikinis. We fight aliens. Like, you know, we work hard. We play hard. But man, it's like grossly overestimating the importance of boats. Like, even in wars now on Earth, like, boats are pretty lame, like, of all the things that are, I mean, and then now I just couldn't get over just that fucking two boats and some grandpas beat these alien ships. And it's just, you know, or shit.
It was the Mighty Mo. So come on. And sunlight. So there you go.
Oh,
aliens don't like sunlight. They don't have sun on their planet.
No, twice they mentioned that the planet has the exact conditions as Earth. And they even have a scene where they're like, I put on the shield and it's just sunglasses. Well, then how come if it's just sunglasses, when you take it off on a planet similar to yours, you can't see anything?
I mean, you should know this.
Oh.
This planet Melmac, all right, he says, it's got a green sky, blue grass, purple sun. Right off the bat, this fucker could not see shit on Earth. His vision would be all fucked up. But he's just like, cool, I can see everything.
What? What? So wait, because stuff's a different color on Melmac, that means he can't see anywhere else?
Are all screwed up.
What? Doesn't make any sense.
No, he said it. Again, am I...
He's just describing colors.
Well, yeah, you got a green sky, a purple sun.
But that doesn't mean he wouldn't be able to see. He just comes down and all he's got to say, hey, your colors are all fucking... Are backwards and fucked up. That's it. And then end of discussion. Not, I can't see because your stuff's different colors. Shit!
All right. I mean, you're an expert on alien eyes. You should know this. It's the rods and cones. They're all screwed up.
Exactly.
And we cut full circle.
You were proven correct, Kevin.
Rods and cones. You were right all along.
You've been redeemed.
Yes.
I should have thought that when I saw that scene.
You should have. You failed.
You jump forward on your couch. Those assholes. I was right.
All right. So, what other kind of thoughts, Steven? Do you have any thoughts that jumped out into your brain?
Well, I'm actually glad you said what you said about it. Like the family stuff was total garbage, and like all the acting was garbage. Because I'm with you 100%. But when that first ship lands and you have that ominous like tower just sitting in the water just still, and they go over and they touch it, and then you've got the beams and these other ships coming out, like, that part was actually like, well, this is kind of cool, like,
yeah,
and kind of spooky, creepy, because what's going on, who are these things, is this because they were like, they thought at first it might have been like training or like a simulation or something like that. So that part I thought that's probably was like the best stuff, with like the alien stuff, the ships and the that tower thing. But outside of that, the acting is trash. The alien, you know, the aliens having four fingers and weird like bone goatees, and you know, I don't know. And the weird thing too is like, they kind of destroyed the planet, yet if you weren't a threat, they didn't hurt you,
right?
Like, they scanned you. And if you were green, so they just walked by, but it's like, but you're going to wipe us all out anyway, so why don't you just kill me now? I don't know.
Well, because maybe they're pacifists.
I don't know if that's true.
But you know, again, they have to... even the writers of this movie know how stupid it is, because they have to do all these things to handicap the aliens. Like, there's a dome around it. Ah, the boats would still lose. All right, well, I don't know. Fucking, it's dark. They can't see. Ah, the boats would probably still lose. Ah, well, what else can we do? Like, everyone realizes these boats suck and they would never beat these aliens. And if the aliens knew our technology and were like, we shouldn't go there with four ships because some boats could destroy us, they should have brought, like, more.
Or not be such pussy pacifists and just kill on sight. Because that's the only thing that's the only reason they lost, is because if the guns weren't pointed at them, they were like, all right, they're just chilling. We're going to leave them alone. Yeah. They're out just for a Sunday stroll on the ocean. They're good to go. But if they just go, something we don't know, kill it, they win easy.
Oh, yeah. They were too 100%. Busy taking turns.
Yep. Aliens are like pussies.
And the part with the grandpas, like, walking slow-mo, I laughed. I laughed. It was like, please don't. Please don't. I had, both of my grandpas were in World War II. I love vets. I love all that stuff. But that was the cringiest, like, did you say propaganda earlier? Just naval, like, yep. That was just gross. It's like, put those old men away. They ain't going to do nothing. Stop. Stop.
Yeah. And I shouldn't say that, because if there's any naval people that would hear this, they might jump down my throat. But, like, I'm pretty sure New Age people could figure out how to run the Missouri. I don't think the technology is that different. Well, I mean, technology is probably a lot different, but it's still, you know, I don't know.
They probably learned all that old stuff and the new stuff.
Yeah, because I'm pretty sure there's a course at the Naval Academy that says, hey, in case all the new ships go to shit, you guys got to know how to use the old ones that we have in storage somewhere. No,
probably no. It could be. And you notice the director Peter Berg, he was in the movie.
Yeah, he's, and one, I'm of the radar, sure, guys.
He's a big military naval, like, doesn't he do like Wounded Warrior or something like that? He's a big he pushes that crap all the time. Again, I don't have a problem with military or anything like that, but he's always pushing that stuff.
Yeah, well, if that's true, that's probably why he did that stuff the way he did with the Missouri and the old guys and stuff, and gave them such a part in it, you know, to celebrate that ship and those guys.
Totally.
So, could see that.
Still cringe.
This is totally, this is one of my notes, but this is totally off of the movie, but it's something that I noticed. The reporter or the anchor is Purdy from Parks and Rec. Yeah. Have you guys not noticed? Have you guys not noticed that's the only role he plays?
Yeah.
I didn't even catch that.
I'm not kidding. I've seen him in a dozen things, and he's always an anchor or reporter.
When I saw him, I freaked out.
Yeah.
I freaked out. And then I started laughing because one of my favorite bits was when he's reviewing movies and he reviews E.T. And he's like, Perd gives us the thumb down for not being realistic enough. I love that, man.
And then you guys noticed Rami Malek in there, too?
Yeah.
Yeah. I was like, whoa, hey, that's the weird guy from all the stuff now.
It's Freddie Mercury.
Yeah. So, I mean, what? Rihanna's in this movie. She's not terrible, though. No, she's.
I mean, no one's good, but she's not the worst actor in this movie, which tells you something too. Disturbia.
God. We just stare at Rihanna for the next 10 minutes. I love me some Riri. Rihanna, if you're listening, my wife would be okay.
Oh.
You're on my list. It would be totally acceptable. So anyways, and then, so let's see. I have other notes here, like, when they're firing upon the alien ships, here's the note that I wrote. Pew. Pew. How come not bang, 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 bang?
Yeah.
Did you notice that? They've got those guns that all had, it was like, bang. Bang. But then later on, it's bang, 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 bang. Why not do that? What are you doing? Use all your firepower and shoot it at them. No, just like, that was so stupid. And then another one that I wrote is when those big silver balls come and start destroying the infrastructure and stuff. I wrote, maybe you guys, I said, hey, they're taking out the freeways because stop the trucks, stop Tommy Boy. It's true. But I didn't get that part. It's like, why are you destroying the freeways?
There's access to the mountains.
You think so? You think that's what they were doing?
I'm pretty sure they said it at some point that all that they kind of carved out any way that you could easily get to the mountain.
Oh.
They knew because even they relied on boats, as weak as Kevin has pointed out. They have like one thing that flies, and they just use that as kind of like a carry-all. And they fly it to the mountain, and then I don't know if this is the correct order, but then those wheels are supposed to cut everything that can stop anyone from getting to the mountain. But because what's her name and Fake Legs was already up there.
Oh. Lieutenant Dan.
Oh.
Horrible acting, by the way. Horrible acting. Like, I know why he's in the movie. It goes back to that, let's get a vet in here.
Wounded warrior.
Thank you for your service.
Well, it's horrible, like, yeah, acting. Join the Navy. Even if you get dismembered, you'll still be badass, and you'll be part robot, and, you know. And
you'll act really monotone.
I think he was actually a Marine. Just point of order there. I think he was a Marine.
What's he doing in the...
Well, because that was just a rehab facility. There was lots of legless, armless people there. Thank you all for your service.
They all go to Hawaii, you know, Magnum PI after their service. It's just Hawaii.
He goes from barely being able to walk in the beginning to like hand-to-hand combat, punching a metal armored suit that bullets can't penetrate and winning.
Well, he felt like a warrior again. Aliens have to come down to make you feel whole.
And speaking of the cones and rods again, it wasn't daytime when he ripped the helmet off of that guy, and it was all blurry. He couldn't make them out or anything.
It was overcast.
Those are prescription helmets.
Well, now can someone tell me why when the nerd guy went in there to get his phone or whatever he got? I think it was a phone, wasn't it? Or
satellite type of phone thing.
Yeah. The alien was there, grabs the case, but then lets him go? Do we know why that happened?
Well, because, again, he's not a threat. So it was almost kind of like a, chill out, buddy. You're okay. I'm not going to hurt you. Just now get the hell out of here.
But I'll allow you to go hurt us.
Well, he didn't know. Because he read the guy as a big puss, just like we all do. So he's like, you're good. Just like when they scanned, I'm not going to call him Lieutenant Dan or Robot Guy. The one guy. I wish I could remember his name, damn it, so I could call him by his name.
The guy in the mountain?
Yeah, because they were just like, well, you're not a threat. You're not all human. Which is actually
what they... They had robot suits on. He should have been more of a threat. They're like, oh, he has armored legs.
He is our equivalent. Kill him.
Right.
You know, and on the ship, when the jackass brother is fighting the one guy and he gets him to follow him out to the deck, those guns make noise when they move.
Oh, yeah.
So you're telling me as they're out there and Riri points that gun at that dude's face, he didn't hear it. You know, I mean, come on, guy. You're an advanced alien life form. You don't hear a big freaking however many millimeter ton giant pew-pew gun behind you moving right to your face. Give me a break.
They're like 2 decades advanced. That mint tops.
Yeah. So.
Well, and wouldn't that blast have really hurt what's his name too? That was standing right there. Like just the pressure from that explosion and that cannon should have hurt what's his name.
He'd be concussed, eardrums blown out.
Pretty sure.
Nah, he jumped off. He's good. The railing protected him.
I didn't like how there was so much forced. Sorry, I'm kind of running with this. Comedic relief.
Oh.
Like everything, it was trying way too hard. Like the chicken burrito stuff.
Ah.
Like first of all, too much. The bad acting, bad story. But like the comedic relief and like the. Every minute they could sneak it in, even in like the worst moments, they had that redhead kid that was with Riri all the time. He was always saying stuff that was supposed to be comedy, and I didn't know. None of it was funny. Garbage.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I'm gonna be honest. I don't have a whole lot more to say about this movie.
That's it.
No.
I mean. I could have used more Riri.
It ended fast. Did you see it? Did you notice how like quick it just kind of wrapped up? Like they blew up the mountain, and then the next scene, like they're getting awards. It's like, wait, are we going to clean up the bodies? Talk any more about this? Or
nah,
that was just Star Wars style. Like Death Star blows up. 20 seconds later, they're getting awards and credits roll. And
I guess it felt a little rushed.
I think they're just like, mic drop. We did it, guys. We did it.
Yep. We defeated the alien horde. We're good to go.
There's nothing to worry about. They'll never come back now, ever. 5 years. with better sunglass technology.
When I was looking up pictures of Rhianna, I didn't click on it, and I should have. Was there a Battleship 2?
What? No. Well, I don't know. Was there?
Let's see. Battleship 2. 2019? No.
What?
No, there wasn't. Will there be a Battleship 2 movie? Battleship 2 is set to release in May 2021.
Oh, no.
No.
That can't be right. Well, because we know that's not going to happen, but... Anyways, so let's see. More Riri. There should have been way more Rhianna. There should have been more Liam Neeson's.
Yeah, he was barely in it.
Maybe
more Battleship, since it's named after a board game. They only technically played it for like, what, 2 rounds? And then that was it?
Yeah.
It was like, even the director's like, this is kind of stupid to make a game. Like, if it was just a Navy movie, like, where you're fighting aliens, you could get away with it probably even more. But it was based off of a board game, and they only kind of played it.
Yeah.
And you're not allowed to move in Battleship, so they weren't even playing it right.
It cheated.
It's true. The froggy alien ships. Why make them look like frogs?
I don't know.
They were like frogs or those water skipper things, you know?
It's
like,
yeah.
Why chin beards?
And where was our submarine and our other thing and our other thing?
Yeah, where was the dome? Where was the frigate?
Yeah.
We needed a frigate, a tugboat, an aircraft carrier. Oh, those were outside the bubble.
Yeah, but there's no bubble. There's just an invisible wall. There's a wall.
But it was a force field. Remember when Boomer ran into it? That was the pilot's name on his helmet, Boomer. And then he exploded when he ran into the force field. Not good.
How fitting.
Okay. So, are we ready to rate it? Or, okay. Let's see. So, the acting storyline, we've already decided that was trash. But the graphics, all that kind of stuff that could have went on in any other movie and been a great movie was pretty good.
Yeah.
So I'm going to give it 3.5 spiky alien buttholes.
3.5. It looked like their chin. Their buttholes look like their chin.
I'm just imagining that's what the hair on the rest of their body looks like.
Oh, God.
Armpits. Well, and then you know that, you know, you're safe back there. You don't got to worry about any foul play in the backyard. It's protected. All right. Next.
You know, even though the visuals weren't bad and the CG was good and Riri was in it, I still found myself yelling out loud at this movie more than any other movie we watched. And so I'm giving it a 9.9 buttholes.
Damn.
And I'm leaving Riri's 10th of a butthole out of it. And that's the only reason it's not a 10.
Whoa. Talking about Riri's butthole now. Now it's a party. All right. Next.
I'll give it 7 because as much as I like the CGI and like spaceship and the sci-fi stuff, it was garbage through and through. The acting just made it so much worse. It erased any cool points, so I'll give it 7 spiky buttholes.
See, it's hard not to think the rest of the hair on their body looks like that.
It's true. That's a good point. It's valid. Yep. Your science is sound.
Yeah. Okay. So again, that was our episode about the 2012 movie Battleship, starring Liam Neeson's and Rihanna and other people.
Mm-hmm.
Rami Malek's in it. So if you want to go see him. Turtle from Entourage is in it, if you want to go see him.
The brother was Skarsgård. He's been in some stuff.
The older brother, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. He dies, by the way.
Yeah.
Spoiler alert. So, yeah, that was that episode. And this is just a reminder. Check us out on the socials. Twitter, Instagram, Facebook. What is this blank? YouTube popping off, blowing up. We've got like 700,000 subscribers now. All right, everybody, that's our episode. Thanks for listening, and go do all that other stuff I told you to do. Okay, bye.
I'm on a boat, motherfucker, take a look at me. Straight floating on a boat on the deep blue sea. Busted by night, wind whipping out my coat. You can't stop me, motherfucker.